Hello everyone, good afternoon, and hope you all are doing wonderful. You are most welcome for the webinar, basically on the topic called Automating SDLC Software Development Lifecycle Using Pipeline. I am here, presenter, a host of the session, Mudassir. I'll be introducing myself in some couple of minutes. Now, why this session is arranged and what agenda we are going to cover in today's session. So it's a webinar, so I will be going to introduce the most trending CI/CD tool in the market, which is Jenkins actually. But directly get into the Jenkins, it is very, really important to go through some of the topics. So you will see some of the agendas have been mentioned in front of you that we are going to cover throughout the session. So the first agenda, we will be understanding what is software development lifecycle, okay, why it is required, and how it is currently or maybe earlier it was executing or going on in the industry. So as of now, most of the things are manual and we wanted to automate it. And this session is organized to understand how you can automate your software development lifecycle with the help of some tools like CI/CD tool, Jenkins or GitHub. Now, after that, we will be introducing what is CI/CD. Later that third session, third agenda, we will be going to discuss some of the trending CI/CD tools in the market. Fourth, the crux of the CI/CD tool is basically pipeline. So pipeline will be used to automate entire lifecycle, and it will be supported by almost all CI/CD tools. So our agenda will be how it is used in Jenkins. That's why I'm going to introduce Jenkins also in this agenda. And the last part of the session will be covering two demos, basically, okay, how pipeline can be configured and how pipeline can be automated things. Okay, so this is the agenda. Let's see how we can cover in given stipulated time. So let me introduce myself. On behalf of Koenig Solutions, as already I have welcomed you all to this webinar topic called Automating SDLC Using Pipeline. My name is Mudassir Marik. I'm from Mumbai, India. I possess almost 13 plus years of experience as a corporate trainer, and I am associated with Koenig Solutions since last almost 3 years. I work in Koenig Solutions Private Limited as a senior corporate trainer. And my area of expertise is actually starting from system administration in Linux and all the DevOps tools, most of the tools, what industry is using to automate their end-to-end lifecycle of software development. So I will be dealing with almost all the tools of DevOps technology. I am the person who basically create, design the course plan and deliver the training to all the delegates within India as well as overseas. And I have delivered the training online mode to almost all continents of the world. And I visited almost 4 continents of the world to deliver the quality trainings on behalf of Koenig Solutions. I possess a couple of certifications, which is not, part of this agenda, but just to give the confidence that you are at the right place. I am Red Hat Certified System Administrator. I am Certified Kubernetes Administrator. I am Certified OpenShift, specialized in containers. And I am Certified in SUSE Rancher Manager. Okay, so almost all the containers and orchestration platform I do take care of in my daily, day-to-day life as a part of training job. So this is my small introduction, crisp introduction in front of you. So let's get started into our topic or the first agenda, introduction to SDLC. So most of you must be working as a software developer or administrator. So what is SDLC? Very first thing, SDLC stands for Software Development Lifecycle. So it basically possesses number of stages right from planning to deployment and maintenance phase. So there are a couple of stages like planning, design, okay, coding, testing, deployment, maintenance, release, all these stages, a combination of stages, we will call it as software development lifecycle. Okay, so this is a simple definition of SDLC. In SDLC, basically there are phases. So each phase comprises of some steps to be carried out so that a software or the product can be released nicely and maintained properly. So we will be starting from analysis, okay, taking the requirement gathering and all this thing. Then we are going to design the system, followed by we are going to discuss about development in multiple area. For example, someone looking for .NET, someone looking for, let's say, PHP, open source, vendor specific. After the development of the products, the industry are going to test it. After the testing, we are going to basically allowing it to be accessed by our end customer. That process is nothing but a deployment. Once you deploy your product, the deployment deployed product is really need time to time maintenance so that my software can be run properly and it will run without any flaw or error. So current market of SDLC, most of the people are following all these stages in a manual phase. So there is a separate analysis team, there is a separate designing team, development team, testing team. Each team is basically doing their own job and they work in a team so that each one can perform by its own well. And by the end, our company as a goal, we can produce a good software that is qualitative, yeah, and as well as it is basically excellent in performance. Now, SDLC is basically a life cycle, okay? And here we are going to use manual procedure. And because of the manual procedure, there are delays and there are miscommunication happening into multiple teams. Being a MNC, for example, analysis team is sitting in India, whereas designing team is sitting in, let's say, UK, whereas development team is sitting at US. So there could be a gap of communication in multiple teams due to their geographical and the time zone restrictions. Now, what is the agenda of our concern, our topic? We wanted to automate all this software development lifecycle by collaborating each team on a single platform with the help of some DevOps practices. I repeat, our essence of the session is we wanted to collaborate all the phases of the software development lifecycle by collaboration so that each team can perform a nicer product, can perform well as the software development lifecycle we deliver the software will be a qualitative software. So we will be basically avoiding the time gap between this and miscommunication through the collaboration. Okay, how this can be happen, we will continue in the discussion in upcoming session. Now, if you use the SDLC, what are the benefits of SDLC? So almost all the company, no matter you are following automation or manual intervention, in both the cases, most of the companies are using SDLC. So using SDLC benefit are basically structured approach, clear project milestone, risk will be reduced, and yes, collaboration will be improved. But that is not as improved what we are going to discuss in our DevOps practices. But yes, without SDLC and with SDLC, there is a huge difference between the collaboration. So currently, till this point, what we discuss is everything is happening in a traditional approach and it's a manual procedure so far. So for example, analysis team doing a job and hand over this to design team. So if there is a gap between time zone, for example, analysis team from India is forgot to report by evening to the UK team by today evening. There is a 1 day gap in just informing the decision and the work task. So to avoid this bridging, we wanted to collaborate all the teams on a single platform with the help of some guidelines and the practices that we are going to carry out and discuss in upcoming session. Now, this slide is basically introducing you a CI/CD concept. So what is CI/CD? Because software development lifecycle was manual, now we wanted to automate. So if you come across the automation, the two phases of automation are divided into two parts. One is called CI, which is called continuous integration. Another one is called CD, what is called continuous deployment. Okay. Now, what is CI/CD? By the nature, by definition, a set of practices that automates process of integrating, testing, delivering code changes, ensuring faster and more reliable software development. I discussed already in the previous session, previous slide also. Currently, all the phases were manual. Now, with the help of CI/CD procedure, we wanted to automate. So the important agenda of session and important agenda of discussion is basically we wanted to automate the process of integrating, testing, and delivering the code changes. For what? Ensuring the faster and the reliable software deployment. Let me share you one example. For example, one of my developers have changed something. So that change, if you wanted to incorporate automatically into the production, that change need to be updated on the collaborative repository. That change need to be tested, and that change need to be built. And later that build has to be deployed in a production server. So whatever I discussed over here, if you wanted to automate, there is only one way to automate, and the way is called CI/CD, continuous integration, continuous deployment. So this is a simple definition. Now let's understand more deeper what is CI and what is CD. We discussed about SDLC in the previous chapter, previous slide. Here also we are going to see only almost that phases: plan, code, build, okay, release, deploy, operate. Some of the diagrams you will see some different stages. Don't confuse about it. It's totally fine because it could be it is a customizable. Now that SDLC we wanted to automate. So if you wanted to automate in software development lifecycle, there are two important words and two important phases we need to understand. We need to always carry on. First is called building the application or building, and second one is a deployment. Okay. When I say building, it means if you take a simple example of Java code or Python code, you have 100 files of Python code that will be work as a simple module, let's say login module. So they are not directly going to implement it like that. The software that is Python based 100 files, you need to compact in a single consolidated box, and that box is nothing but application build. Okay, .py file. If you talk about mobile application development, the file name .apk will be your build. In case of container, the container image is the product of build. So whatever we wanted to deploy, whatever we wanted to deliver, in first phase, it needs to be built. So that building is basically carried out with the help of concept called continuous integration. And the deployment is done by the rest half portion of this life cycle is called continuous deployment, CD. So CI stands for continuous integration, CD stands for continuous deployment. Combination of these two makes CI/CD. Continuous integration, continuous deployment. So in CI, basically we are going to build the application, okay, with the help of multiple platform, because I have given a couple of example. If you use Python, you should be using some Python based environment. If you are using Java, there has to be some Java based like JVM or something. If it is container, you need to create a containerized image that should be run on any of the platform like Linux or the Windows. So whatever type of build of application you wanted to have, that you are going to achieve with the help of CI, and the end product of CI is nothing but build of the application. Now the same build used by the team called deployment to deploy the product into the production server. Okay, so that basically product will be used. If you talk about APK, that APK will be used to deploy in some production server. If you talk about container image, the same container image will be used to deploy in some production server so that my end customer can access this application, which is made with the help of collaboration of my development, testing, deployment, and all the teams which basically take care of entire workflow of CI/CD. Okay, so here we discuss about CI, we discuss about CD, continuous integration, continuous deployment. Now, one quick information for all of you. This is not something magical because we are approaching the pipeline part. So this is not something magical. When you talk about coding, for example, you are creating a Python-based code. So you must be looking for some Python-based environment. If you look for creating a Java-based application, you must be looking for some Java-based environment. For example, you can go for, let's say, Eclipse or NetBeans, or you can go for VS Code. So all these tools we will be basically using into this stage. Now, when you build the application, building needs some environment. Like if you talk about Java, it's a JVM, okay, or it's a JDK. So JDK is a building tool, or we need a building application building tool for Java-based application. If you talk about container image, if you all, some of you are from the containerized environment, you know the procedure called Docker file or container file will be used to build a container image into this build stage. So what is the magic behind this? Okay. Whatever we were using manually before this and it at a proper stages, all the stages tools we are going to use same, but in collaboration. When I say collaboration means what you are doing, the next person is known about it. What you are doing, the next person is known about it. Okay, there are standard what we are following so that we can use a centralized repository to put the message or the code. So no matter from India, if I upload something, my colleague who is sitting in the UK can understand and can get directly access of that code just by sitting at his own physical location. And not only that much, once I upload it, the person who is responsible for building is going to be informed that yes, XYZ have uploaded the code, please review and build the application if it is required. Okay, so by this, I mean, throughout this part, we will be going to collaborate all the people with all the tools. So in CI, we will be going to use the tools which are looking for building of the application. And in CD, we wanted to implement, we wanted to collaborate all the people and the tools who are responsible to deployment of the application. This is a process of simple CI and the CD. Now, if you go for the benefit of CI/CD over normal software development lifecycle, SDLC, please remember the important agenda over here is a faster speed, or I should use the word fastest speed. You cannot achieve the speed which is higher compared to as you will be achieving the highest speed with the help of CI/CD procedure. You will be going to deploy the application, build the application error-free. You will be going to deploy the application which is on an automated base, automated manner. Okay, so all these some features are the benefit of CI/CD, what we understand over here. Now, we have understood what is CI/CD. Now, who is responsible to perform all this continuous integration and continuous deployment? So the tools who are responsible to automate this previous life cycle and who have the capability to automate entire life cycle of your software, these tools are nothing but a CI/CD tools. Now, what all these available in the market? So actually, if you see this diagram, you will be seeing that DevOps or the CI/CD follows all these tools or some of the tools or similar to these tools to automate the things. Okay, only the CI/CD tool is not responsible to do all the tasks. CI/CD tool basically take help of all the tools available in all the stages and will automate the procedure. So for example, if you talk about build, you will be using Maven, and Maven will be integrated with the help of along with the CI/CD tool to build your Java-based or Python-based or Kotlin-based application. Now, popular trending tools in the market. So what are the tools you have available in the market? Some of the tools you can note and you might be already gone through. If you just Google it, you will get the list of that. According to my own personal experience, Jenkins is something widely used tools in the entire globe to use as a CI/CD tool. Jenkins is one, GitLab is second, Azure DevOps is third. Okay, we have Jenkins, GitLab, Azure DevOps, then we have Tricircle, Trivis, Circle CI, we have Azure DevOps, we have there are a lot of tools are available. If the list is very big, okay, so you can choose any one of the tool which is needed for your own, which is compatible to your environment. Let me inform something. Jenkins is why this is one of the most popular, because it's a fully open source. And since it is fully open source, most of the people are basically gone through or going through Jenkins as a part of CI/CD tools. So we have a couple of available solutions. You can cross verify which tools are available and which tools are convenient for your organization, and you can integrate them for your automation to achieve the automation. Now, these are some trending tools available in the market. Since time is approaching a bit faster, that's why name is not important. Now, what are the benefits of having this CI/CD tool? See, being a DevOps person, my CI/CD tool will be sitting over here. And I will be capable, I am responsible to write a pipeline. That is our agenda of the today's session. So that pipeline will be basically executed by some of the tools like Jenkins, and entire automation will be used to automate end-to-end automation. So for example, in my Jenkins, I am going to use Git. In my Jenkins, when I write the pipeline, I will use Maven. For testing, I can use JUnit. For deployment, maybe I can use Kubernetes. For monitoring, I can use maybe Datadog, Prometheus, Nagios, anything. So my pipeline is basically integrate all the tools state use in all the stages as per my requirement. So the backbone of entire automation is a CI/CD tool. And in our session, the CI/CD tool will be a Jenkins. Now, I already mentioned who is the mastermind of this automation. So definitely a pipeline. Now, what is pipeline? Before pipeline, we should understand Jenkins. So we discussed all the tools available in the market, and Jenkins is one of the example of using such CI/CD tools. I already mentioned there are a couple of more solutions available in the market, but Jenkins is most widely used available solution in the market because of their open source and the power of the Jenkins because of availability of the plugins is amazing, enormous. You can integrate almost everything which you wanted to use to automate your software development lifecycle. So this is the power of Jenkins. So it is open source as well as it has almost for all the purpose, there are some plugins available. Okay, maybe the paid or maybe the open source. That plugins will help you to integrate XYZ environment with your pipeline, which is written into the Jenkins. For example, if you are not okay with Maven, you can go with Ant, you can go with any other building tool. If you are not comfortable with, let's say, Kubernetes, you can go with anything like Terraform. If you are not comfortable with Datadog, you can go with, let's say, Prometheus, or you can go with the Splunk, or you can go with the Nagios. So almost all the monitoring tools which are trending in the market will be supported by the Jenkins because of the plugins available to support that or extend the functionality of the Jenkins. So this is the power of Jenkins. So what is Jenkins as of now in a short and a crisp story? It is CI/CD tool. Let me inform one more thing. In industry, software development, MNC or the popular companies who basically looks for deploying the application, which is really efficient and 24/7, it should be agile. So these people are use a different tool for CI and a specialized tool for CD as well. Okay, so Jenkins, though it is powerful to achieve CI as well as CD, but you will come across that some companies are using Jenkins as a only CI and let's say Argo CD as a CD, because Argo CD is a specialized for deployment. I'm not saying Jenkins cannot do the deployment, but some of the speciality is really available So Jenkins is capable to do CI along with the CD, no doubt on top of it. But because of some narrowness or some specialized requirement, people are ready to go to some specialized software development tool who basically follow the GitOps practices. Like one of the possible option is Argo CD. Okay, so that is not part of discussion, but just to inform about alternatives. So Jenkins is basically we are going to use to deploy our application as a CI/CD tool in our session. Now, when you're planning to automate this software development lifecycle, which I started from by 335, okay, I'm discussing the same thing. So basically, when you talk about automating means what, you wanted to perform all these stages by collaborating all the tools available for that stages, and you want all the stages should be carried out, because my webinar topic is only the automatic SDLC. So let me repeat. What do you mean by automation? Automation means you wanted to perform all the stages by collaborating all the tools you needed for specific stage. And all these stages along with the tools should be executed via automation automatically without human intervention. This is called automation. And who is capable to do that? In our case, Jenkins. How? We are going to write a pipeline. Okay, so what is pipeline? In the next slide, I will be jumping to the pipeline part. So what is pipeline? I already mentioned, I promise I'm going to explain a pipeline. So what is pipeline? Pipeline is nothing but, I think most of the people who are attending this webinar, they must be from software development background, or they should have a fair enough idea about writing a code or a program, maybe in a C, C++, Java, Python, Kotlin, any programming language. So you can consider as of now, a pipeline is a program we are supposed to write in some programming language so that Jenkins can automate all these stages. And what could be that language? That language could be a Groovy or it could be a YAML. So you are basically responsible to write a program by considering the factors that I should use all the tools to achieve all the stages to deliver a software, a nice software by the end of this lifecycle, which is build and deploy on top of some deployment server or the environment. Okay, so this is something, a very simple example. I'm going to demonstrate also, don't worry about it. Now, to understand the pipeline and whatever I discuss, we need to understand the workflow of the Jenkins. So I request everyone, I will be taking maybe 5-7 minutes to explain you this part. And this is something backbone of Jenkins. If you understand this, you earn entire expectation of this session. So let me explain that. Since I'm using my Jenkins as a CI/CD tool over here, this is my developer team. So I have three developers. Let's say one is sitting in India, another one is sitting in UK, third one is sitting at US. All the developers are performing their development task to achieve a single goal. For example, they are informed to create a login module by today. So they divided the task among these three developers, I mean, among each other. And let's first 100 line code will be designed by the developer one, second will be designed by developer two, and third 100 line will be designed by developer three. As soon as the people do, because they are working geographically restricted and a different timing. So the Indian person who finished their job basically push the code to some of the solution called SCM, source control management server. One of the example of this, because the terminologies could be very dangerous for you. So one of the example of this is either GitHub or GitLab. So the developer from India will push onto the collaborative repository. Collaborative means this is a common repository among all the developers. If he does the job, he pushing the code. Second developer does the job, he pushing the code. Third developer does the job, he is also pushing the code. So there is no required of communication among these three people because the division has to be done, made, and that division divided modules is implemented by each developer. And ultimately by the end of the day, everyone is uploading on SCM server, which is a GitLab or the GitHub. Now, as soon as they finish their job, they upload, and their job is done. So when you have SCM in place, you are basically Jenkins configured to check that repository. And as soon as commit happened by any developer on this SCM, my Jenkins is basically identify the changes. As soon as Jenkins identify the changes because of commit happened or performed by any of the developer, my Jenkins pipeline start executing. And in pipeline, I have written the code to automate my software development lifecycle. Building, testing, deployment, everything will be done by my pipeline. So see, the automation is basically carried out by the Jenkins. As soon as commit identified, detected by the Jenkins, my pipeline, we can configure a pipeline to start upon without intervention of human by 12 midnight or any moment of time. Okay. Now, as soon as you start this, a CI/CD will be taking place, building and the deployment. So once the building happened, there could be chances that any error comes into the building because of some mistake made by my development team. So that can be possibly informed by the Jenkins to appropriate developer. That capability also my Jenkins has. So any developer do the job is mistake, he will be notified, hey XYZ from UK, US or India, you made that mistake, please work and re-upload your code on the SCM again. Continuously, the flow will continue until the code is verified, build properly. After the building, there could be possibility of manual testing or automated testing. So for example, if there is an automated testing, my build application will be tested by the tester. And if everything goes fine, my software will be deployed in a production server. If any issue comes during the testing, again, my Jenkins has the ability to inform that to the same developer or the team, and they will work upon, they will resolve the issue, and the lifecycle continues till my tester approves the product through the routes by performing some testing. Now, once the testing is fine, everything is cross-verified, all the type of testing has been done. Now, my software is ready to release. So that deployment is also an automated procedure into the production server. So this procedure is called CI/CD. And if you observe carefully, the entire discussion was automated. No manual intervention was made. This is a process of Jenkins. Okay. Now let's jump to the, because a lot of theory we have discussed. So I will be planning to at least couple of demo, small demo that I can finish within 10 minutes. Just a second. So I will be planning with two demo. First demo, I will be writing a pipeline in my local Jenkins, local instance of Jenkins. And I will show you how automation can be performed. And second demo, I will be having my pipeline in SCM GitHub, and based on changing that, I will how the changes will happen. So let's go quickly for the demo, and this will be the last part of my discussion. And once we complete this, we will wrap up the session. Okay. So to explain that, I will be needing the environment to be changed, and I will be using my lab setup over here. Okay. So just to save the time, I have already ready. I'm already ready with the Jenkins setup is working already on my one of the machine. And here I'm going to create a first job to demonstrate you how the local pipelines can be used. So I'm going to use new item, and I'm giving the name. It could be anything, pipeline job. And I should select the pipeline because I wanted to write a pipeline. Okay, and so just click OK. We will be designing the job, which is pipeline. The description would be fine if you can keep even empty, but in industry, you should follow some good description. Just to save the time, I'm not discussing some, the effort, the stuffs which are not or less important over here. So I'm not writing some description. I'll be OK. Now in build trigger, currently I wanted to use the manual trigger. It means I wanted to build by my own. Jenkins is not responsible to build the application. I wanted to build it my own because it's the first demo. Let's go manual, and then second demo, we will implement a automation. So I will be writing a pipeline. So in pipeline, there are some sample pipeline available. So I will be using pipeline script. And if you check here, there are some sample pipeline. So I will be using a ready-made pipeline, which is Hello World. Okay. Now, what is pipeline? I already mentioned the pipeline is a program. You wanted to write it to understand and to achieve entire automation of your software development lifecycle. So it's a groovy code. If you want to get more into that, go to the Jenkins documentation. Okay. And there you can see all the things are available. Okay. All the things are available. So all the tutorials, just because of short of time, I'm not able to show you the appropriate guidance. But if you go to this documentation, you will get all the support available, how to write the Jenkins pipeline. So now here, this is my pipeline. Should be starting with the pipeline code. And my pipeline is basically consumed or having number of stages. What is stages? These are the stages. Okay, these are the stages. Sorry. Yeah. So if you want analysis stage or design stage, accordingly, you should use the stages. So just to keep it the simple, I'm using two stages over here. Okay. The first thing, I will be using my stage hello, and I'm writing hello world. And second stage, I wanted to write, just a second. And I'm copying the same section and writing. Okay. And I am writing, this is my another stage called welcome. Welcome. And here I'm writing a welcome. So only there are two stages I have written that are very simple. So the first stage is hello, second stage is welcome. I can save. Now, see, there is no build happened so far. So I wanted to build now. So let me click on the build schedule, and you will see building is happening. Yeah, it's a successful build as expected because it's a very simple demo. So there was no errors found over here. So if you go to the console output of this build, you will see there are two stages. Okay, stage hello, having the output hello world, okay, and stage welcome, having the output welcome. Okay, this is a simple demo how we can use pipeline in my Jenkins. So you are supposed to write, because I'm repeating again, it is a 1 hour demo, that's why I cannot go in a deeper discussion. So basically, our job as a software development or DevOps person, our job is to create such a complex pipeline for writing this one. Okay, so we can write one configure over here, and I use the ready-made pipeline, and that pipeline we are supposed to write by our own way, by our own will. Okay, this is one demo. Second demo, I wanted to do the automation with the help of SCM, source code manager. So to see that, I'm opening my GitHub account over here, github.com. And in GitHub, there is a repository already I created whose name is Jenkins. Yeah, Jenkins. Now, please remember this repository already I created for saving the time. And when you use SCM from the GitHub or GitLab, remember the pipeline file should be named with Jenkins file only, compulsory. That's why I have given the name of the file called Jenkins file. And this file is my pipeline from this SCM. So what is written into that? See, I have three stages: build, test, and deploy. In build, I just use the echo, building, testing, and deploying, just to demonstrate. Now, see what will happen. Now, what this demo expects? This is my GitHub repository whose name is Jenkins from my account, and this blue color is my Jenkins instance. I will configure the automation that as soon as commit happened to this repository, they should be informed to Jenkins. And based on the changes happened into this repository, my Jenkins will build the job automatically. This is the outcome of this demo. Okay, that we wanted to implement. How we can implement? So currently I have used the repository whose name is Jenkins. This is my account. And in my account, I'm using the Jenkins repository as a SCM. And from that, I don't mention any file, but I will just use the name of the file, Jenkins file, automatically by my Jenkins, because it will be detected by the Jenkins because of this name, and it will be treated as a pipeline only. So let's go to the Jenkins instance and let's perform the automation. I'm going to create another job. Let me go to the full screen. And in the full screen, I'm creating another job. Okay, guys, just 5 minutes, because this demo is something important. But once we conclude, we will stop for the day, for the session. So I wanted to use SCM pipeline. You can give any name, SCM pipeline. And you can use pipeline project. Okay, you can use any type of project, but let's go with the pipeline. Okay. Now, here you can give some discussion, that's fine. Now build trigger. This is something very important. I wanted to build this on poll SCM. What is poll SCM? My Jenkins keep checking the repository over a period of some time. So I wanted to configure poll SCM. So click, and here I wanted to give the schedule. So since it is a testing demo, I'm giving 5-star. What do you mean by this? Just for your information, this is my Jenkins is going to check for the update in the repository for every minute, though it is not suggested for production, please remember. Okay, but just it is testing demo, I will be using for every minute so that my testing will be done. I mean, my building will be done faster. So I'm using poll SCM. I can, or rather than saving, let's go and use the pipeline. Now here, I have to use the pipeline from the SCM. Now, once you mention SCM, it is going to see Jenkins file. Now it is going to use the SCM. So I need to give the repository. So it is coming from Git and it will ask me the URL. So you have to specify a proper URL, https://github.com/mudassir-devops/jenkins. This is my URL. Okay. And since it is prior public repository, I don't want to add the credential. I have added this and we will go and save it. Okay. Now, first I'm building it just to inform you. And then I will go for commit. So first time, let me check everything is scheduled properly. Change the type of, and I can do it. It's fine. Just a second, guys. Git is not installed on the machine and Java is not supported. Okay, this is happening because of Java. Okay, let me verify. Maybe the URL is, someone is taking talking about URL is not cut. Okay, thank you very much. If it is really help, I can go to the configure in the pipeline. HTTP Okay, thank you very much. Good observation. Thanks a lot, my dear team. https://github.com/devops/jenkins. Okay, save. Thanks. Thank you for good observation and thanks for supporting my duty. Okay, so now see, if you see over here, console output, and if you see, there are three stages it should be running, okay? The first is build, and we are seeing this message, building name. Second is test, testing name, and third one is deployment, deploying name. And it is finished successfully executed. Now, just to save the time, sorry guys, I'm just going a bit faster, and let me do some commit changes into this. So here in deployment, I'm going to type some different messages so that we can track the things, we can track the changes. So in deployment, I'm just writing deploying by Mudas. Okay, any basic change I wanted to do so that I can identify. Now, as soon as I commit the changes, you will see the power of automation, and this particular job needs to be run third time automatically. You can see. Because it is going to check in every minute. So I did not build it. If you see, if you verify, go to this, the first changes what we have done, let's verify to the console output. And in console output, see, started by an SCM change. It is not manual. So this is the proof of automation. Second thing, the changes should be done available over here into the third stage. Okay, so this is how we can implement the collaboration and the automation, end-to-end automation with the help of software development, with the help of Jenkins as a CI/CD tool to automate your SDLC automation to be achieved in your life cycle. Okay, thank you very much everyone, and let me check any questions we have so we can go with that questions. Okay, thank you everyone for joining the session. If you have no queries, so one quick reminder for all of you, so if you, since you attended this website, I mean this webinar, you can go to the website, our clinic website, and you can reach out to all the webinars available or planned in future also. So you can find out, select appropriate suitable webinar for you, and reach out to us to attend any webinars, and the recordings are also available on the website. Okay, so we have one question from Priyaranjan. One point, how to use Maven for build in Jenkins. So Priyaranjan, we have the Maven tags, Maven plugins. Okay, if you go to Jenkins, let me show you quickly in Jenkins instance, you can go to this section, dashboard, manage Jenkins, and manage Jenkins, you can go to the plugins. Okay, and here we can search for the Maven. So if you go to the available plugins in the Maven, you will see a lot of available plugins for Maven, and you can appropriate Maven integration. Can you see? If you install these plugins, you can use the Maven, and the instance need to be added to the configuration part also. Okay, configuration part also, that can be done in manage Jenkins, just a second, manage Jenkins, system, allow me a minute, control F, you can search it for the Maven. As soon as you install the Maven field is available, like you see over here, like SSH. Okay, as soon as you add the plugins, you will find that Maven field over here, and you can install or you can give the name to that instance, and that instance will be used for the automation from the Jenkins itself to build the application on the memory part. Okay. You're welcome. Any other question if you have? SVN, how can I link with Jenkins? I have one question. I'm using SVN. How can I link with Jenkins? So can you just elaborate? I mean, for what your purpose you are using SVN? Little bit of this question is Jumak Madiha. Mahadi, sorry. One more question is there from Tayyab. How to use .svn as a kit? So it is quite possible. So similarly for SVN also, we have the plugins. And we can add any SCM for instead of Git or something. That's totally fine because Jenkins works with almost all the platforms. Okay, I'm not properly able to remind the name of the plugins, but it is available. If you just go and search it, you will get it in the plugins. The next question is from the Tayyab. So how to use the Docker in Jenkins? So Docker integration is also can be done on the with the help of in Jenkins. So same, see Jenkins, everyone remember one thing, Jenkins is powerful just because of the plugins. So for Tayyab, your question, if you just go to the manage Jenkins in the plugin section, there are some plugins for the Docker also. So just go to the available plugins and search for the Docker. At least 4 to 5 plugins are available for Docker part. So you, if you use Docker API, you need a Docker, you need a Docker build step, okay? So the plugins you need to add, and you can use the same runner or the instance of that Docker to build your application without writing a Docker command into your script, into your pipeline. So one more addition to you, all this, guys, if you don't understand anything, just right click on that and open in a new tab. The documentation for that plugins will be opened. Go through it. You can check the vulnerabilities. You can check the functioning. You can see the purpose. And the documentation of Jenkins is really amazing. Okay, so Jenkins power is because of your plugins. Okay, anything else? Most welcome, Tayyab. All good. Looks like. Okay, I think I have covered all. Yes, Adam. I think that's it from my side.